Any scientific method used to estimate the age of the Earth requires making assumptions, and that includes radiometric dating. To illustrate the assumptions, let's imagine something simpler. Suppose you walk into a room and see a flask with 300 milliliters of water in it sitting under a dripping tap. If the tap is dripping at 50 milliliters per hour, how long has the water been dripping into the flask? We don't know without making assumptions.
It would
be 6 hours, assuming the flask was empty when it was put under the tap, that the tap had been dripping at a constant rate the whole time, and that the flask had not been moved or tipped over. If we don't know those things, we can't be sure how long the water has been dripping into that flask.
Yeah, and it's the same for radiometric dating. We have to assume we know the amount of each isotope present when the rock cooled, and we don't. We have to assume that the decay rate has been constant, and there are processes that can affect decay rates, and we have to assume that nothing has been added or taken away from either isotope. Bottom line is, dating methods don't work because we can't be sure if the calculated date is accurate.
Yikes. Yeah. You know, there's a simple way to check if it works. Just test a rock of known age and see if the dating method gets the right age.
That should do it.
Now, this has been done many times. In 1992, samples of the lava dome that formed at Mount St. Helens in the early 80s were tested by two reputable labs. Results came back at between 340,000 to 2.8 million years for rocks that were no more than 10 years old.
So that's a fail.